My name is Janice and I am an addict. Now, the reason I say I am an addict is because every recovery program says that once you're an addict, you're always an addict. So you're probably wondering, well, what is it? Is it drugs or alcohol, maybe food or sex? No, it isn't any of those things. My addiction is much more innocuous, sly, and subtle. My drug of choice is people-pleasing. Now, thankfully, I am in the recovery stage now, but I have to be really careful not to fall back into the trap of trying to get validation and approval from other people at the expense of my own well-being and sanity. Do you guys remember back in high school when we all tried so desperately to fit in and to get people to like us? Well, people pleasing is kind of like we never outgrow that high school situation. We're always feeling like we don't belong, and we're looking for ways to be seen, to be valued, basically to be loved. And we go to great lengths to make sure that this happens. We say yes when we mean no. We compromise our morals to get people to like us. We overextend ourselves to the point of burnout and exhaustion. Basically, we do everything for everybody and meet their needs, but we don't meet our own. Oh yes, and we hate confrontation. Throughout the years, Oprah has interviewed guests and has talked a lot about the dangers of people-pleasing. And I try really hard not to put people up on pedestals, but when Oprah speaks, I tend to listen. And she is a self-proclaimed people-pleaser and has struggled with this for a large portion of her life. Actually, I wonder if that's why she gave away so many cars. It was like, you get a car, you get a car. And I swear I was the only one who did not get a car. But she has made so much progress in this area that she's a shining example to me. Well, she had a guest on her show by the name of Dr. Harriet Breaker, who wrote a book called The Disease to Please, where she laid out how people-pleasing is actually a serious psychological problem. And they both agreed that there are epidemic numbers of people who struggle with this self-imposed pressure to please others at the expense of their own health and happiness. So why do we do it? It's because we feel like this on the inside. We don't feel good enough. We feel unloved. We don't feel valuable. And many times this comes as a result of emotional wounds from our past. Now, it is important to note that not everybody takes people pleasing to the extreme like I did to warrant it being called an addiction. But many people do have this tendency or these people pleasing habits. So let's do a little test. I'm going to ask you some questions and just see how you answer these. Do you have a hard time saying no and setting boundaries? Do you struggle with low self-confidence and feelings of not being good enough? Do you agree with people simply to not rock the boat and not have conflict? And lastly, are you worried about what other people will think or say about you? If you've answered yes to any of these questions, then you may have some people-pleasing tendencies. We do need to be careful because tendencies can turn into habits, and then habits can turn into full-blown addictions. So we want to make sure to kick the habit when it's still a little baby habit instead of letting it grow into this huge monster-size habit. You might also be wondering, okay, Janice, fine, but what's the big deal? Aren't there worse things in life than trying to make people happy? And what's funny is I used to think that myself. As a matter of fact, I was very self-righteous in my addiction. Look at me. Look at what a great, sweet, kind, generous person I am. But what I didn't see is that I was unintentionally lying and manipulating people to get them to like me and approve of me so that then I, in turn, could feel good enough, could feel loved. And the reason why it is so important to kick this habit early on is because if you don't, you will lose your voice. You will become a shell of a person. You'll say yes when you mean no, so you'll be untrustworthy. You'll wear many masks and you'll forget who you truly are. And the worst part is that the true, authentic you will never get a chance to shine. Those are just a few of the heartbreaking consequences of being a people pleaser. On the upside, we are really good in bed. But if you resonated with what I have said up until this point and you think that you were caught in this trap, I want you to know there is hope. I am living proof, because if there was an Olympic gold medal given out for an event called people pleasing, I think I would have won that. I was pretty good at this people pleasing thing. So if I can change, you can too. And I want to lay out a simple, but not necessarily easy formula for kicking the people pleasing addiction. Now, the cool thing is you can also use this formula to break other bad habits as well, or other addictions. The formula goes like this: awareness plus healing wounds plus self-love equals our desired outcome. Let's start with awareness. Awareness is simply knowing. It's knowing consciously who you are. Your thoughts, your beliefs, your fears, your patterns of behavior, your motivations. It's the ability to see yourself clearly. Tasha Urich, an organizational psychologist, researcher, and TEDx speaker, said that even though most people believe that they are self-aware, it's actually a really rare trait. In a study that she did, she found that only 10 to 15% of people are actually self-aware. Oh my gosh, you guys, this means that 90% of us are walking around this life without seeing ourselves clearly, without knowing who we truly are. Do you truly know yourself? And how do we become more aware? Well, there's a couple ways. One of the ways is this purposeful introspection, where we really dig deep and ask ourselves questions. Now, it has to be the right questions to really get somewhere, but that's one way. The second way is through mindfulness and tapping into our own inner knowing. Lao Tzu, an ancient Chinese philosopher and writer, said this: at the center of your being, you know who you are and you know what you want. You have the answers. That's brilliant. I encourage you to sit in stillness for 5 minutes every day. Sit in stillness, close your eyes, and listen to that small yet powerful voice that lies within you. Component number two to our formula is healing wounds. People pleasing is caused by these emotional wounds that were inflicted on us usually when we were younger. My dad was a Christian missionary who lived a double life as a gay man for many, many, many years and lied to everybody around him, myself included. That was one of my emotional wounds. Now, for you, it could have been that you were bullied or talked down to, maybe abandoned or abused. Those are all wounds, and they take time and courage to heal. There's usually a lot of deep pain involved. I went through a divorce 9 years ago, and I was really devastated. So I went looking for psychological help. And after seeing a lot of different therapists and professionals, I learned a couple things about healing. The first thing is that we have to acknowledge the wound. We can't just sweep it under the carpet and pretend like it doesn't exist. The second thing is we have to accept that what happened happened, that it's in our past. And the third thing is we need to release it, forgive it, let it go. And that is one of the most difficult choices you will ever make in your life, is to forgive and let go of past emotional wounds, things that were inflicted upon you. But it is the best choice you could ever make, because we could be stuck in that victim mentality, blaming everybody else. It's your fault. It's your fault. Or we can take personal responsibility and step forward into this empowering, amazing future that we get to create. The choice is yours. And the third component to this formula is self-love. Now, I know self-love sounds really cliche, and it's a term that's thrown around a lot, but it is so important, because if we build up enough love inside of ourselves, we won't have to go looking for it from anything or anybody outside of ourselves. That's what's beautiful. We won't need to get it from anybody else. Think about it. If you truly like yourself, you're not too concerned as to whether somebody else is going to like you or not. You're good either way. Now, self-love starts the moment we begin to trust ourselves. Promises that we make, that we keep. Goals that we set for the betterment of ourselves that we reach. I want to be very honest with you. I used to hate myself. But as I did things that I thought were impossible to do, I began to discover this new love and appreciation for myself. And what I did is I just wrote down a list of all of my fears, everything that was holding me back. And I decided that I was going to walk through each one of those fears. So basically do the things that scared me to death. That's how I came to run a marathon, when I could barely run around the block without feeling like I was going to faint or pass out. It's how I came to master the Spanish language and become a court certified Spanish interpreter. Empecé a interpretar delante de jueces y abogados, hablando un idioma que me encanta. And it's how I came to compete in a bodybuilding competition at the age of 42 years old, when there were days I didn't even want to look at myself in the mirror. Everybody can walk through their fears. You can walk through your deepest fear. And on the other side of that is beauty. So I encourage you to do that. I encourage you to develop that self-love muscle. Because when we have enough love inside of ourselves, that love spills out onto everybody else around us. And it is that love that will change the world. So let's go back to our formula. Awareness plus healing wounds plus self-love equals freedom. Freedom, what a beautiful word. Freedom from fear, freedom from addictions, freedom from anything that is holding you back from living your best life, from being who you are truly meant to be. This is a picture of me free. Here's what I want you to know beyond a shadow of a doubt, and that is that your authentic self matters. Your thoughts, your voice, your passions, your gifts, those are all unique to you. If you don't share them with the world, no one will. You are here to share your ideas and your story. You are here to break addictions and to be set free. It is time to wrestle with the dragons and to ride the big waves. You are here, my friends, mis amigos. You are here to build your future from scratch.